morning. My name is Chandrasekhar. I am a faculty of CSE department. Now I will be teaching the topic correlation and correlation analysis. Before we go to the topic, we need to understand the importance of understanding the correlation analysis. In the data analytics or in the data science field, there are a lot of problems which could affect the accuracy of the output. And one of that could be having improper dimensions, that is the dimensions which are unnecessary are existing in the data set, and we may have to remove them, identify and remove them. Not only that, correlation analysis can also be used in problems like clustering, classification, regression analysis to address the curse of dimensionality, for dimensionality detection, etc. Let us see each of them with an example. For example, there is a data set which has two columns or two parameters. One of them happens to be the date of birth, another happens to be age. You know very clearly that age and date of birth are one and the same, except that the date of birth has the details up to day and month. Age would be also can be represented with a decimal number. So in a data set, if I have two columns representing the same, functionally the same values, it could affect the accuracy of my classification problem, regression or clustering, whatever it is. Right? So the primary step is to identify those columns which are similar to each other. So there comes a correlation analysis. Correlation is defined as a linear association between two random variables. It is expected that the data set, the variables in the data set are independent of each other, and there is a degree of dependence between them. Okay. The dependence may be very high, dependence may be low, or dependence may not be there at all. We will try to understand that by looking at the output of correlation analysis. So correlation analysis shows us how to determine both the nature and strength of the relation between the two variables. So we are looking at two points. One is the nature of the relationship. Is there a dependency? Second is strength of the relationship. If it exists, what is the strength of that? When variables are dependent on time, correlation is applied. So this part for a while let us neglect. And the final point to understand is the correlation coefficient value lies between plus 1 and minus 1. Plus 1 would tell that the two variables are highly correlated. Highly correlated to the extent that functionally the both variables mean one and the same. For example, date of birth and age. Minus 1 would mean the variables are once again highly correlated, but in an inverse fashion. That is, when one variable rises, the other variable goes down. For example, whenever the inflation is very high, the purchase capacity of the people goes down. So they are inversely correlated. And a zero correlation indicates that there is no relationship between the variables at all. Right? So we cannot predict that the variable 1 changes, then how does the variable 2 change? It is impossible to predict because both of them are independent variables. For example, we have names. Names of the people have no way relation with their parameter, say age. A correlation of minus 1, just now I told, is a perfect negative correlation. So a correlation of plus 1 indicates a perfect positive correlation. So they have been categorized into three types. Not necessarily we need to remember what are the types of categorization, but let us see each of them. So in type 1, we are discussing about the nature of the correlation.